Good morning students. So let's start the last topic of this chapter. So another activity, that is activity 3.14, is given in your book. So here in this activity we are showing the expansion of gases on heating. So if you take a capillary tube and take one droplet of a colored liquid and put it like this and heat the test tube in which it is put, then you will find that the drop of liquid moves towards the exterior end or upwards in the capillary tube. So this rising of this drop of water shows that the air inside this empty test tube expands on heating, and that is the reason it pushes the drop of the water in the tube to upside. Okay, so when we cool the test tube again, the drop will again come downside. So this shows that gases also expand on heating. Now let's start the next topic, chemical change on heating. So a chemical change is a change in which new substances are formed. So those formation is permanent. So after chemical change, we cannot change the new substances into the previous substance because the properties are very different. So whenever we burn a candle, this is a very common observation and everybody's home, we do this. So whenever we burn a candle, then what happens? Wax melts down and this slowly the candle starts decreasing in size. So this happens because the vapor of the wax reacts with air and forms a new substance that includes carbon dioxide and water vapor. So this is a chemical change. See the break. So the intermolecular force and the intermolecular space are responsible for determining the mass of matter. So it is true or false? Yes, it is false. Then the molecules in solid only vibrate about their fixed positions. Third number, the liquids are free flowing because the molecules are loosely packed. So the answers will be loosely packed. Gases do not have a definite shape and volume. The intermolecular force between the molecules of a solid are very strong. That is true. Then a change in the state from a gas to a solid is called sublimation. All the three states of matter expand on heating. A chemical change involves the formation of a new substance. So for classwork, you will define these terms: mass, matter, intermolecular space, intermolecular force, and diffusion and melting. Now let's see the book exercises. So this is B prompt, question number A, page number 56. So here, first fill in the blanks. Let's match the fill in the blanks and see what is the answer. So mass is the measure of quantity of matter contained in a substance. Then cohesive force is a force that tends to oppose motion. Here actually frictional force in physics you might have read that it is the force that tends to oppose motion. But in case here in matter, the intermolecular force or the cohesive force is that force which binds the particles at a fixed position. Okay, so if it is high, then the molecules will be fixed at their fixed position, just in case as solids. And in case of liquid, this force is weaker, so the molecules are able to move. And in gases, it is the least. So gases molecules move the most. So in this context, cohesive force will be the answer. Okay, then, or you can write the intermolecular force of attraction. You can write anyone. Liquids are free flowing because the molecules are loosely packed. In gases, the intermolecular force between molecules is very weak. Okay, then the space between the molecules of a substance is called intermolecular space. And the gaseous state of a solid is called sublime. Okay, then see the true and false. So matter is composed of extremely small particles, that's true. A molecule has an independent existence and also exhibits the property of matter, that's also true. Liquids have strong force of attraction, that is false. Solids have less density, that is false, because it has more density than the liquids. Both the particles and gases, move rapidly in all directions, that's true. Brownian motion is caused by the collision of molecules, that's also true. So when molecules collide, they move in zigzag fashion. Then choose the correct option. Which of the following statement is not true for the mass? See, mass cannot be zero. Mass is the quantity of matter. Mass is constant everywhere. When gravity is also not acting, then also it is constant. But when amount of gravity acts on a mass, it is termed as weight. So this one is incorrect. Then question number 2. Dash refers to intermingling of particles and of different substances on their own. So the answer will be diffusion. If you see the table 3.1, you can see the definition of weight. So it is the amount of force of gravity acting on mass. So now you know why that option was incorrect. Then question number 2. Dash refers to intermingling of particles and of different substances on their own. So the answer will be diffusion. Then which of the following has closely packed particles? So the answer will be solid. Which of the following diffuses quickly? Yes, you are right. That will be gases. Which one of the following can be compressed to some extent? That will be liquids. So what process of conversion of liquid into solid is called? That is called freezing. So if you have any doubt, then you can refer to the we have done one very small experiment here. That is with the compressibility, the syringe one. So you can see the second syringe, see the second syringe which contained water moved a little. So here only the liquids will be the answer. So it is clear here. So we will write that. Okay. Now let's see the third one. Conversion of match the following. So conversion of solid into a liquid is called melting. Conversion of gas into a liquid, that is called condensation. Conversion of solid into a gas is called sublimation. Conversion of liquid into a vapor is called. This one. So your flowchart will be there like this. So it's the same. First part is the same. This is the first part. Matter, living, non-living. Then when you will write living and natural and man-made, you have classified. Then you classify this both. Okay. So this will be classified. This natural and man-made will be classified again as solids, liquids and gas. Okay, so like this you will write. These two will come like this. And that will be solid, liquid and gas. See B number. So here then you will write like this. You will make a flowchart like this. Okay, solid, liquid and gas. So solid, melting you will write the name of the process. And by heating it occurs, so solid melts into liquid. Then when liquid is heated up, again it changes into gas. The process name is vaporization. So here by mistake I have written downside, you can write upside. And heating the downside, any way you can write, both ways are correct. Then again when gas cools down, so condensation occurs. And when liquid cools down, the process name is freezing. And on cooling it changes into liquid. Then solid directly changes into gas by sublimation. Okay. So here you will write into gas. And here you will write heating. And again it will turn into solid on cooling. This is the second flowchart for the changes in the states of matter. The give reasons and question number C and at length questions I will discuss in the next video. Okay.